Dear participants, greetings of the day and a very warm welcome. I'm Nandita Singh, Professor of Education in Punjab University, Chandigarh. Today, we are going to take up a module on digital Bloom's taxonomy. With changing times, teaching learning methods are also undergoing change. Use of digital technologies in classroom have changed the way students learn and absorb the educational content. Learning platforms, softwares, and digital devices are together creating countless new ways to modify teaching learning processes. Well-defined mobile and reliable applications are being created to teach students, help them practice their learnings, take assignments, and manage their schedules. Education is being imparted through flexible and non-intrusive formats. In its report, The Future of Learning, What Kind of Pedagogies for the 21st Century, UNESCO suggests that children need to develop new technological competencies compared to previous decades. Learners need skills such as critical thinking, ability to communicate effectively, innovate and solve problems through negotiations and collaborations. 21st century pedagogies need to fuse traditional framework along with digital technology for an enriching learning experience to students. Today, we are going to talk about such a synthesis between traditional framework and technology, which was developed by Andrew Churches in 2009, called the Digital Bloom's Taxonomy.
Hello, ma'am. I'm Priyanka, and I'm doing my research in Punjab University. May I have the pleasure of asking you a few questions about Bloom's digital taxonomy? Ma'am, what's Bloom's taxonomy? Hasn't Bloom's taxonomy been used for a long time by teachers for developing thinking skills?
Yes, you are right. Benjamin Bloom in 1956 published a framework for categorizing educational goals known as Bloom's taxonomy of educational objectives. He proposed a pathway from lower order thinking skills to higher order thinking skills. It categorized the human behavior into three domains, that is cognitive, affective and psychomotor. This framework consisted of six major categories which fell under the cognitive domain, that is knowledge, comprehension, application, analysis and synthesis, and the final was evaluation. Each of these levels is arranged from simple to complex learning, also from concrete to abstract, where each level is a must to go to the next, that is from lots to hots.
Ma'am, you explained about Bloom's taxonomy. Then how is it going to be different from the revised form of it?
45 years later, a revised version of Bloom's taxonomy was developed by Anderson and Krethal, in which two of the six original categories were reordered and verbs were used rather than the nouns to describe each category. For example, knowledge was replaced by the word remember. Rest of the words like comprehension or understanding, application, analysis, evaluation, and creation. Now what they did was, instead of synthesis, it was evaluation, and the last was creation.
Ma'am, the revised version of Bloom's taxonomy came in 2001. Then why was there a need for Bloom's digital taxonomy? I would also request you to elaborate on this digital taxonomy.
Andrew Churches developed digital Bloom's taxonomy based on Bloom's revised version and extended the categories given by Anderson and Krethal into digital classroom environment. This creates a hierarchy of learning activities in a digital environment. Contents of digital Bloom's taxonomy are like remembering. We all know that remembering means to retrieve information, facts, definitions, and it includes actions such as recognizing, listening, describing, identifying, retrieving, and finding can be associated with remembering. In this level, a student is expected to identify and relate with similar examples. Reciting, matching, searching, visualizing, and quoting are the other actions in the digital world that correspond to remembering. Understanding is the second level in digital's Bloom taxonomy, and it implies deriving meaning and relating concepts. Actions such as interpreting, summarizing, inferring, paraphrasing, classifying, and exemplifying, etc. These can be related with this level. Such activities enable students to look to link similar concepts and processes for categories, constructs, meanings, whether figurative, verbal or graphic, and also filter unnecessary information available in the plethora provided in the digital world which is not related to their subject concerned. Other digital activities that can be related with this level are advanced searches, commenting, annotating, generating, discussing, etc. Applying is the third level of the taxonomic structure. In applying, it relates to putting the information and knowledge gained into action, like implementing and executing. In this level, the student uses learning materials like presentations, models, simulations, charts, etc. and applies them to learned concepts of processes depending upon the situation, like making a PowerPoint presentation, video clip, blog, Word document and presentation, uploading or sharing it with others on digital platforms can be associated with this level. At the same time, editing an already provided source of information or contributing knowledge on discussion forums, debate boards or rooms are a few other activities related to it. Analyzing means breaking concepts into parts and subparts with the purpose of determining how the parts are interrelated with each other and how they make a whole when put together. In other words, it is breaking the abstract into a concrete and making sense out of it. Activities such as comparing, organizing, deconstructing, structuring, and integrating are related with this level. Along with actions such as concluding, deducing, estimating, planning, mind mapping, and prioritizing. The next step is evaluation. The second high order in the taxonomic structure is evaluation, and it implies to determine the exact crux or value by careful analysis of the same. Actions such as hypothesizing, critiquing, checking, testing, detecting, and monitoring. Whereas reviewing, moderating, networking, recommending, justifying and validating are the other digital activities associated with evaluation. In the digital environment, there are varied opportunities for discussion and evaluation of comments and materials posted like articles, websites, blogs, wiki pages, etc. Now, the intellect in its higher form needs to be applied while choosing what is appropriate, relevant and what is not. Critically applying the mind while selecting material from the digital world or while interacting on digital forum is one of the forms of evaluation. And the last is creating. The highest level is creating. It implies constructing together all other levels like remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, and evaluating. Digital activities like programming, filming, animating, blogging, video blogging, podcast, etc., writing, devising, adapting, emailing are all associated with creating. Collaborating it with added features or materials such as graphs, diagrams, illustrations comes in the next step. Other examples of creating would be making a presentation of an abstract idea that generate in one's mind the purpose of other people to go through or analyze it. What we need to understand there is that none of the levels and activities associated can be compartmentalized from each other, and there is much overlapping between these levels as they gradually progress into the trajectory.
Thanks, ma'am, for guiding us on Digital Bloom's taxonomy. Are there any questions which we need to exercise while incorporating this taxonomy into action?
Yes, you're right. As we know, the digital platforms have a plethora of information available on the internet, covering an unending spectrum of information. Thus, we need to specifically train our teachers to sift the essential content from the non-essential. Instructional philosophy is going to be a crucial factor in shaping the future generations and their perspective towards life. Hence, it needs to be evolved as per the needs of the time. Digital Bloom taxonomy is a perfect amalgamation between traditional and modern times without constructing or overpowering any one of them. Thank you so much for asking questions and helping me making the concepts clear. Thank you.